Join Ashra and Merira Kwesi on the Kemet New Know Thyself educational tour to Ethiopia. Brother and Sister Kwesi will emphasize the rich historical and cultural background of Ethiopia from ancient times to the modern day. This unforgettable and enjoyable experience will stay with you forever. Ashra Kwesi is a griot or historian and lecturer on ancient African history and religion. He brings a wealth of information based on his 29 years of study and tour experience in the African Nile Valley. 14 of those years were spent apprentice to the renowned scholar and Kematologist Dr. Yosef Ben Yakinen. Merira Kwesi is the business manager for Kemet New Tours, and she's a lecturer on African culture and history, both ancient and modern, including 19th and 20th century Ethiopia. She has 18 years of research and tour experience in the African Nile Valley. Ethiopia. It's unique in its breathtaking scenery and intriguing cultural and historical sites. This African-centered journey will take you to Motherland, Africa. You'll discover the rich and exciting history of the oldest independent country on the African continent, the place where humanity began. We depart from Washington, D.C. Dulles Airport on Ethiopian Airlines, the national airline of Ethiopia. As we approach Addis Ababa, the excitement mounts. You'll be elated as our plane touches down at Bole International Airport, formerly Haile Selassie Airport. We'll tour the ancient city of Aksum, part of a little-known glorious kingdom. Aksum controlled most of present-day Ethiopia, as well as the southernmost part of the Arabian Peninsula during the 4th through the 7th centuries. They recorded their achievements on the ruins of temples and granite tekenus, or obelisks. We'll explore those magnificent 2,000-year-old tekenus. They are located near the tombs of the Aksumite rulers and are hewn from a single piece of granite.
Hotep Kemenu, you finally reached the great and holy city of Aksum.
Now we're here.
You finally made it to the Aksumite Empire, or what was the seat of the Aksumite Empire. Of these great stelas are still here, and some of them have been dated back to 1,000 years BC, and some believed to be of King Azana around 325 AD, during the time of the Christian emperor that actually predates Constantine. And this one here, about 70 feet tall. I know we saw a lot in Egypt of the ancient monuments, but throughout the whole Nile Valley, we see ancient monuments that existed, and the ancient Kushite civilization and the ancient Aksumite civilization. But this is one of the most impressive sites of these ancient stelas here, 13 stories high, and also has the door, symbolic door, as you saw in ancient Kemet, to show this is all part of the Nile Valley cultural civilization. You imagine what the cosmic starry heaven is like here with hardly no lights, with these stelas looking up to the sky, and how they saw the universe.
Another stop in Aksum for our Kemet New Tour group is the Cathedral of Mary of Zion, or Saint Mary of Zion. This is said to house the Ark of the Covenant in a special sanctuary. Legend has it that it was taken from Israel and brought to Ethiopia by Menelik I, the son of Solomon and Makeda.
And this chapel right here is where the Ark of the Covenant is supposed to be. Those of us who are familiar with the Ark of the Covenant, that's where you see the tablet or the Ten Commandments. The tradition of this ark is an ancient African story from the Nile Valley. It did not start in Jerusalem. It started in the Nile Valley. During the time of the Temket, January 19th, this would be a very colorful occasion. The Abanas were put on their colorful garments. They will actually carry the tablets on their head.
We excitedly board our plane to Lalibela, one of the oldest and unique unsung wonders of the world. With our Ethiopian pilots in the cockpit, we soar over mountainous terrain on Ethiopian Airlines to the city of Lalibela. This amazing remote city is the home of some of the most incredible man-made creations, the 11 rock-hewn monolithic churches built by the Ethiopian king Lalibela of the Zagwe dynasty in the late 12th or early 13th century.
All right, brothers and sisters, as you can see, this is a most spectacular sight right here in Lalibela. This is one of the most famous churches. When we see pictures of Ethiopia, this is the one that generally stands out to the world. But it's definitely a most impressive. It's standing on its own rock. It's standing on their own living rock bed, if we can understand, relate to that. It's their own living rock bed that they actually used and carved it out. This was African ingenuity here that built these structures. When we go down and you're standing up on the hill, as magnificent as this is, as you can see it carved out of this rock bed here, but it's even going to be more impressive as you get further down into it.
As we make our way down to the bottom, we notice how each church is superbly carved with a unique architectural style, sculpted inside and out from the bedrock of the earth. As our tour members proceed along the walkways of the church, they notice the breathtaking exterior. These incredible edifices connected by tunnels and walkways remain places of worship today. We travel as an African family, so our Kemet New brothers assist the sisters and elders as we exit the church. Ethiopian Airlines takes us on another exciting journey to Bahadur. The Kemet New group boards the plane for another spectacular sight. Our pilot provides us with a beautiful view of the Blue Nile. The upper reaches of the river are called Abayi and are considered holy by many in Ethiopia. They believe it's the Gihon River mentioned as flowing out of the Garden of Eden in Genesis. The scenic and beautiful Lake Tana, Ethiopia's largest lake, is the Blue Nile's main reservoir and its source. Our visit to this area includes a journey to the majestic Tissisat Waterfalls, which flows from Lake Tana. It's about 20 miles southeast of the lake. Millions of gallons of water cascade over the 1,312-foot-wide cliff that's 148 feet deep. The water creates spectacular rainbows as it thunders over Tissisat Falls, called Smoking Water. You'll see the tankwas on Lake Tana. These are the boats made of papyrus reed. Even though we see the tankwas today in Ethiopia, they date back to the temples of ancient Egypt over 3,000 years ago. This shows that the Nile Valley culture came from the south, from Ethiopia. Our group will visit the African Aga Beta Israel village of the people who are direct descendants of the ancient Hebrews, Solomon, Queen Makeda, known as Queen of Sheba, and their son Menelik I. Here they observe the traditional Hebrew faith.
We have our sister right here. Okay. Tenestele, everybody say Tenestele.
Tenestele.
How are you doing? Or Shalom.
Shalom.
Ashra and Merira Kwesi will present visual PowerPoint lectures on Ethiopian history and culture from ancient to modern times. Highlights will include the links between Ethiopia, the mother, and Egypt, the daughter. We'll discuss the various ethnic groups of the country and focus on the unification of those groups to keep the land free of foreign invaders. It's in Ethiopia that you can see the remarkable way in which ancient historical traditions have been preserved. The past comes to light in the land where humanity began. This preview is an excerpt from a 1-hour, 20-minute DVD entitled Motherland Africa, the Kemet New Know Thyself Educational Tour to Ethiopia by Ashra and Merira Kwesi. To purchase the DVD or join us on the Ethiopia tour, go to kemetnew.com or call 214-371-0206. I'm Isakanalo. That means thank you in Amharic.